Okay, so good morning. So we'll continue with our discussion on moisture thermodynamics. So we started defining many quantities, okay, lifting condensation level, wet bulb. So we first started with moisture parameters, mixing ratio, relative humidity, and mixing ratio, specific humidity, relative humidity, dew point, lifting condensation level, wet bulb temperature, dew point temperature, okay, and then potential temperature, which is the dry adiabat. Then the saturated adiabat corresponds to the equivalent potential temperature. I think we stopped at that. LV into what is theta? Theta is the potential temperature. So the theta is the product of the potential temperature into E the LV omega S by Cp into T. Okay. So, LV is typically some 2250 kilojoule per kg, omegas will be some 10 grams per kg or 20 grams per kg and so on. Cp of air is 1005 or 1.005, temperature will be 290 Kelvin. So, this quantity will not be such a very, very huge quantity. It should not be very huge and very small, then it will be meaningless. Okay. So, this theta E is equivalent potential temperature. Lines of constant equivalent potential temperature are curves which are available on the SQT on P chart. So, it is possible for you to calculate the equivalent potential temperature. Okay. So, I think I gave you the definition. So, the theta E is the temperature of an air parcel when all the water vapor has condensed such that its saturation mixing ratio becomes 0. I think you missed some classes. Theta E is the potential temperature of a, that is the equivalent potential temperature is actually the potential temperature of an air parcel when all the water vapor has condensed so that its saturation mixing ratio is 0. All right. How do you find the equivalent potential temperature? The equivalent potential temperature of an air parcel may be found out by considering the lifting of the air parcel pseudo adiabatically until all the water vapor is condensed and released and the latent heat has fallen out. The air is then compressed dry adiabatically to 1000 HPa, okay, at which point it will attain the temperature equal to theta E. Then wet bulb potential temperature, we saw that also. Point A. Temperature and pressure. What is this? TD. These are curved, saturation mixing ratio, straight lines. Straight lines. How do you get this? Omega equal to omega S. Okay. What is this fellow? What is this point?
LCOC.
Very good. Lifting condensation level. People who miss classes or people who have just missed the point is, basically this is an isobar. There is a T is equal to constant line. So find out, first fix the point on this QT ln P chart. One moisture parameter will be given. If dew point is given already, then there is no problem. Otherwise, omega will be given. Otherwise, RH will be given. Otherwise, specific humidity will be given. Convert it into this such that you get that omega S. That omega S will intersect with your original isobar. That will be TD. Okay. Keep that blue line like that. From here, find out where the theta is equal to constant. That is the potential temperature is a constant. They will intersect and that is a lifting condensation level. Now, from the lifting condensation level, you take a theta E is equal to constant. So, this is a saturated adiabat or a pseudo adiabat. Okay. He is cutting the original pressure at some point. What is that? Very good. That is TW. Please note, that is wet bulb temperature. Now, I will go down a little further. Assuming that this original pressure is not the 1000 hbar and this is the 1000 hbar, if the line joining the LCL and TW, which is nothing but the theta E is equal to constant, which is the subject of our discussion, yesterday's class and today's class, if it is extended all the way such that it cuts the 1000 hbar, then that temperature is called the wet bulb potential temperature. However, if the original point A is already at 1000 hbar, then the TW will be the same as theta W. Agreed? So, you can see first the TW, the wet bulb temperature, is between the dry bulb temperature and between the dew point temperature and the dry bulb temperature. If you are using a desert cooler or an air cooler, it can reach adiabatic saturation only up to TW. You can't reach the dew point, but you can approach the dew point if you use an air conditioner. Okay, so adiabatic saturation. What is the difference between the saturation reached in TD and the saturation reached in TW? The saturation reached in TD is isobaric. Saturation in TW is
adiabatic.
Okay. Now, wet bulb potential temperature is also there. So, in the quiz, I will ask you a solid question where all the parameters are given. I will give you the conditions. I can ask you n number of things, right? Get the dew point, get the real dew point, I will give only one moisture parameter, like let us say omega. Ask you to find RH, ask you to find specific humidity, ask you to find D dew point temperature, LC, L theta, theta W, whatever. So, you should have patience and do one by one. So, it is not very difficult, but you have to be very meticulous and systematic, okay. And you have to use the right line. After LCL, if you again use theta is equal to constant, you will go somewhere, you will come back to the original point. After the LCL, you have to use theta E is equal to constant, alright. Now, I want to introduce one more quantity called MSE. Any guesses what this could be? Is the moist static energy of air. Okay. The MSE can you identify the three terms? First term is it gives you an idea of the total energy available with the air. The total energy of the air has got three components. Component one is, please feel free, what? Enthalpy. So, the component one is enthalpy. The component two is geopotential, which is a reflection of its height, okay, potential energy. And the third is the energy contained in the form of latent heat. So, which is the dry part and which is the wet part? First two are dry, very good. So, this is dry static energy. First two are dry parts, right? What did he say? Dry static energy. Now, as Z increases, what happens? Assuming that all the processes in the atmosphere are adiabatic, as Z increases, please tell me what happens to each of the three components. T will? Cp into T will decrease. What about the second part? It increases. For the dry, if it is for dry air, if it is dry air, the third part will also decrease, correct? Is it correct or am I making a mistake? Okay, so the first two you are fine, right? No, I made a mistake. For dry air, what about this? It's not under consideration. Remains unchanged, right? Now, for moist air, now tell me what happens to the third term. Decreases, correct. Okay. However, the sum of the three is a constant. So, in atmospheric processes, you can consider involving moist air. You can treat MSC to be constant and work out problems with that. If height is chosen as a coordinate, height is chosen as a coordinate means phi is chosen as a coordinate. Are you getting the point? So, that is also possible. Now, I will have to teach you something called Norman's rule, which is extremely useful. You already know about this, but let us state it formally. And then we will solve a massive problem which will take about half an hour for you to solve on this QT lone P chart. We will discuss something called the Chinook. Wind in the Pacific, which starts from the west of the Pacific. Chill air comes on the windward side of the mountain, gains moisture, goes up and comes on the right side. You will see that you are getting surprising results. Okay, we will solve that in today's class. Okay. Please tell me what are these two points? T, LCL. W. What is this? Theta W. So, this is also an isobar, but not equal to 1000 hpa. Have you taken this down? Yeah. Now, I'll tell you the rule. You already know this, but it's good to have it in the notes. Please complete this. You can focus on that. I've already indicated on the right side, but this is more. Shall I start speaking? Okay. Please take down. The Norman's rule, NORMAND apostrophe S, the Norman's rule states that, on a QT ln P chart, the LCL of an air parcel, is located at the intersection of the theta line, that passes through the TP, of the air parcel, and the theta E line that passes through TWP and the omega S line that passes through the TDP, TDP of the parcel. It is, I am just stating the obvious. Okay. So, it is a three-way interaction. You can start from mid bulb temperature, or you can start from dew point, or you can start from this thing, and everywhere it will all converge to LCL. Alright. So, now I will show you two presentations, how to get the lifting condensation level. Okay. On this QT ln P chart, first locate the isotherms. Locate the isobars. With the help of the isobar and isotherm, you know the point A, which is given by TP. The two yellow lines will intersect and you will get the point A now. Point A, whose coordinates are temperature and pressure. Fine? Now, please look for the saturation mixing ratio lines, omega S equal to constant and omega is equal to omega S. Apart from temperature and pressure, we will give you one quantity for A. Let us assume that is omega. Find out where omega equal to omega S and have that yellow line. So, this is, okay, I will just go, I cannot write this presentation. Okay. Omega to omega S and identify that line. What happened? Now, where the original isobar cuts the omega equal to omega S line, that is the TD, then look for the dry adiabat, take the dry adiabat from A and locate it, and then this dry adiabat, and this omega S, which is cutting the isobar at TD, they will intersect, that is the lifting condensation. Okay. So, how do you get the wet bulb temperature? Look for the isotherms, look for the isobars, intersection, fix the point. One more moisture parameter will be given. Look for the saturation mixing ratio, find out where the saturation mixing ratio is equal to your omega, which I have given 8 grams per kg to 12 grams per kg, whatever. Fix the dew point, look for the dry adiabat. Look for the one which is originating from A, that is theta equal to constant, and then look for this omega S line which is shooting off from TD, get the lifting condensation level. Now look for the orange color line, which are the saturation adiabats, or theta E, equivalent potential temperature is constant, that yellow line is fixed, then that intersects this original isobar corresponding to A and TD, and you get the wet bulb temperature. If you go down further, assuming that at A, the pressure is not 1000 H bar, you will get the theta W. Is it okay? Please take down this problem. Problem number 38. An air parcel at 1000 hpa, an air parcel, please take down the problem, problem number 38. An air parcel at 1000 hpa has a temperature of 30 degree centigrade. An air parcel at 1000 hpa has a temperature of 30 degree centigrade, 30, and a mixing ratio of 14 grams per kg. What is the TW of air? Now I will not ask what is the LCL. When I say now you are, we are advanced now. What is the TW of air means you have to get LCL, isn't it? Okay, what is the TW of air? Question mark. Problem continues. The air parcel is lifted to the 700 HPA level. The air parcel is then lifted. No, not then. The air parcel is lifted to the 700 HPA level by passing over a mountain. The air parcel is lifted to the 700 HPA level by passing over a mountain, and 80% of the water vapor that is condensed out, and 80% of the water vapor that is condensed out by the ascent, AS CENT, that is with the ascent or the lifting, right? So I come again. The air parcel is lifted to the 700 hpa level by passing over a mountain, and 80% of the water vapor that is condensed out by the ascent is removed by precipitation. Determine the following quantities. Temperature, potential temperature, mixing ratio, and the wet bulb potential temperature. So, determine temperature, potential temperature, mixing ratio, and the wet bulb temperature of the air parcel after it has descended down. Determine the temperature, potential temperature, mixing ratio, and wet bulb potential temperature of the air parcel after it has descended down to the 1000 HPA level. After it has descended down to the 1000 HPA level on the other side of the mountain. You understand? Why it is getting lifted up? Some wind is there. Let's not get into that story. So, the wind is bringing it, and then it is rising, and then it is raining on the mountain top. Then some moisture is removed, wind is carrying, it is going to the other side. Now the funda is, you will get some surprise in yourself. What is the final temperature of the air which is hitting the city or the town which is on the other side of the mountain? Originally the air is at 30 degree centigrade. You will get some surprising result. Okay. So please start one by one. It is like a typical quiz question, okay. Once you have learned moisture thermodynamics, this will be the, don't expect me to ask a 15 mark question on what is the LCL, okay. All right, so T equal to P equal to The first question was, what is a wet bulb? How much did you get? I got 28. So we call that point 1, A or whatever. I am calling it as 1. So the relative humidity as 1 is, okay, it's not required, but I will find out. Okay, whatever can be found out, we will find out. All right, now dew point temperature. Dew point temperature is 18. Correct. Okay, for the benefit of other people watching this, we'll just show it. Which is steeper, the omega S or the isotherm?
Omega S.
Okay, so if I draw like this, I am not making a mistake, right? Okay. Okay, I got this. So this is my, it's too much, which okay, this is the point A, point 1. Then I go all the way here. This is my TD. Fine, dew point. Now keep this. They are intersecting. $850. All right. So the LCL is 850 h bar. We have not even answered the first part of the question, right? So we are still quite an involved problem. Now let us try and answer the first part of the question, which is find the wet bulb temperature. Let us find the wet bulb temperature. So I will use the green. The theta E is equal to constant. It cuts this somewhere. It may correspond to Bangalore, but the problem is it's not 1000 H point Bangalore. So Bangalore is already at some height. So you want to start with Bangalore, you have to start some 920 H power or 900, correct? Are you getting the point? Bangalore is not at 1000 H power. Because Bangalore is some 900 meters above sea level, no? Chennai is at 1000 H power, but 30 degrees is not Chennai. That problem is there. Maybe today, maybe it's 32, 33 now. Okay. So the wet bulb temperature is 22. Out of 20 marks, you got 6 marks or 7 marks already. Now the difficult part starts. Now it is further lifted. It is further lifted to 700 H power. How will it get lifted? Huh? This is theta equal to constant. So from here, will it follow the green line or the pink line? It will follow the green line. I'll take the. So now, this is ...850 H power. Okay? Draw one more line, 700 H power. Okay, for those people who are highly mathematically inclined, with a scale height of 7.5 kilometer, what is the height of the mountain at 700 H power? Just tell me, 2 minutes. Use the hydrostatic equation. Tell me the height of the mountain. Assuming that zero, or P naught equal to zero, right, at 1000 H power. Can you calculate or not? You can, right? 2.67 is reasonable. Western Ghats is 2. Ooty is 2300 meters. Anaimudi 2695. So 2.7 kilometers reasonable. Okay, Western Ghats height is about 2. So it has come up to 700 HPA. So you must have this in mind. So 700 H pump. So what the lifting condensation level will be about 1.5 kilometers, right? 1.2 to 1.5, because you guys are telling me this is 2.6. 1000 is 0, 1000 H pi is 0, 700 H pi is 2.6. So I assume that 850 will be around 1.2, 1.5. So that cloud base height will be around 1.5. Now from here you are taking it all the way up to 700 by using this. So I am following this. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Now what should you do? At 3, what is the temperature? That you can easily find. At 3, you have to find out. Isotherm. T equal to? So it is very cold now. The air parcel has become very cold. I will just check my answer. This is not asked. This is not asked. But anyway, we will find. Okay? This is not asked. Because I asked on the other side of the mountain only, but after it descends. But anyway, whatever you can calculate, you calculate. I know that you are proceeding on the right track. Now some difficulty, now some difficulty arises. Because from its mixing ratio is how much? Its mixing ratio is always 14 grams per kg. But now when it has reached 700 H power, what is omega s? So how much it has to shed as precipitation? 4. But out of that 4, it is not shedding everything. How much is it shedding? 80%. How much is that? 3.2 grams. So the remaining 0.8 will stay with this. So what will be the omega? What will be the omega of the air parcel when it starts descending after it has hit the 700 H power will be the maximum it can take 10 grams per kilogram plus whatever it has not precipitated, or I will come in some other route. Originally it had 14. At 700 HPA, it is legally allowed to have only 10. The remaining must be thrown out. That is 4. Out of that 4, 80% is actually precipitated. That means 3.2 grams. So out of 14, 3.2 are thrown out. So the 10.8 is remaining. Agreed? So 10.8 grams per kg is remaining within the air parcel. With that 10.8 grams per kilogram, what will happen to that? Okay. It is coming down. Correct? When it comes down, which process will it follow? Saturation adiabat. When it will follow the saturation adiabat till it reaches a height at which omega s is 10.8. Are you getting the point? After that, all the moisture would have been removed. It will follow dry adiabat all the way up to 1000 HPA. Is that clear? You understand what I am saying? Vivek, you are following what I am saying? So, some fundas are there. This 10.8 funda you understood, right? From the 10.8, what it will happen? It will again come down. It will again come down to a pressure at which, when it intersects, the omega s will be 10.8. What is that height? I think it is 720, 730, whatever. Thereafter, when it goes down, it won't follow a saturated adiabat, it will follow a dry adiabat. Correct? Then it will follow a dry adiabat all the way up to where? 1000 HPA. Then if you see the temperature, you will get a startling result. Please do that. 40 degree centigrade, 36 or 38. So what's actually happening? You get cool air on one side of the mountain. The air, the wind takes it up, it sheds it moisture. On the other side, you get hot winds. This is called a Chinook wind. So it happens in the Rockies in the US, it also happens in the Alps in Europe. Okay? Some little bit should also happen in the leeward side of Western Ghats, still be some Tamil Nadu, I mean, for example, in what is the other side of the Western Ghats? If you look at Tamil Nadu, maybe that Sivakasi, Virudhunagar, and this side of Madurai and all that, no? West of Madurai. The other side you will have all Kerala towns. Huh? What is that, Vishwajit? That's all Western Ghats. Eastern Ghats is our, I am going to West. So, when you cross Kerala, this side there is Tamil Nadu, right? After the Western Ghats, there is some portion. That's why you've got the Sivakasi and all these places where they do this firecrackers. There are only 5 rainy days out of 365 days. Why are all the firecrackers factories situated in Sivakasi? 360 out of 365 guaranteed no rain, because they are on the leeward side of the mountain. The Western Ghats protects them from rain. But the other side, it just rains like mad. The other side, you know that. The other side, if you cross the Western Ghat, it will be so green, that side, Munnar and all those places. Okay? So, what is the temperature you are getting? 720, yeah? Then from here, okay. Now the parcel is going down. At 700 HPA, unfortunately, it is super saturated. Correct? This is the funda, okay. Now the parcel is descending at 700 HPA, it is super saturated. First it descends along the theta equal to constant till omega equal to omega at that level. This is what is that level?
720 HPA.
Okay. I don't want to rub that, okay. What is the theta? Theta, t is 36, no? What is theta? Huh? 38, isn't it? Theta, potential temperature, 38. T final? Same. So what did I ask? Determine the temperature, potential temperature, mixing ratio is 10.8, mixing ratio is 10.8, wet bulb potential temperature, same 1000 HPA, wet bulb potential temperature is the same as before, correct? Wet bulb potential temperature does not change, right? So, yeah, now just 1 minute, I think some people want to, Lakshmikant wants to go to the next class. So, I will just quickly summarize. The net effect of an ascent followed by a descent, the net effect of an ascent followed by a descent is as follows. The net increase in the temperature and theta of the air parcel, you have seen that. Decrease in omega, RH, TB and TW. No change in theta E or theta W. Wet bulb potential temperature is the same, potential temperature theta E is the same, but why are you so surprised? Net change in omega, it started with 14, it has come down with 10.8, so it has decreased. So relative humidity also has decreased, moisture has decreased, right? The relative humidity has decreased. You can check what will be the relative humidity at the final point, it would have decreased, okay. Then the TW would also have decreased, okay. But there is no change in the potential temperature or the wet bulb potential temperature. So you get a very hot air on the leeward side. So this phenomenon is called Chinook wind. I will show you some pictures and some, we will get into the internet and look at Chinook winds for 5-10 minutes. And I will solve this problem on this QT non P chart for the first 15-20 minutes. Then I will solve one more problem involving all these wet bulb and all that. Before we start on with a new sub chapter in this, where we look at the stability of an air parcel. After it goes up, we will go further, it will be uncontrolled or it is convectively stable, unstable, neutrally stable and all that. Thank you very much.